It's inconceivable to me what it must have been like at 22, having grown up presumably aware of the show, watching the show, fan of the show, to walk in there and suddenly be on the staff.
Yeah, it's very weird. Yeah. I mean, you kind of have to pretend like it's not weird, because otherwise it's overwhelming.
You right, go be in cool. And, you be cool.
Yeah, because you just walk in, you see photos of, you know, Bill Murray and the whole original cast and the right. sketches they did that you remember, or Dana Carvey and Phil Hartman together, things like that that you think, oh boy, what am I going to do?
So this is 2005?
Yeah, 2005.
So who's in the cast at that time?
So it's an interesting moment because there was a cast that had been there for the last, you know, few years. So Tina Fey was the head writer, so she hired me as a writer. And then the cast was kind of Amy Poehler, Maya Rudolph, Horatio Sanz, Chris Parnell, Rachel right, wow. Dratch, Finesse Mitchell, Kenan Thompson had just started. So that was the group that was there. And then I started with Andy Samberg, Kristen Wiig, Jason Sudeikis, and Bill Hader.
Well, this is what a great group of people.
Which
right?
is a pretty
coming
cool,
and going.
Both. So it was yeah. a very odd moment. So only for a year you had all that overlap, my first year. Yeah. But coming in with those four was just such a blessing. To, yeah. You know, because they're not only are they now good friends and still get to make me laugh all the time, but right. working with them was a joy.
You write for them. Had to have been amazing.
Yeah, and as a new writer, to work for people that are just also trying to prove themselves and all come up as a group is pretty cool.
Now, I want to talk about that process of writing, but let's go back a little bit.
Sure.
So you had been at the Harvard Lampoon.
Yes.
A famous producer of awesome people who go on to do great things in comedy and in writing and...
Yeah, weirdly, mostly non-comedy until like the... I mean, not non-comedy, but mostly literary people
right.
until, you know, the 70s, really.
Right.
And then Jim Downey, who was a longtime writer at SNL,
right.
was kind of the first Lampoon writer to go into television.
Right.
And he was at SNL when it started or right after it started.
Yeah. Did you go to Harvard thinking, I want to get to work on the Lampoon?
No, I didn't know what it was when I went there.
So what...
I hadn't heard of
what
it.
What was the path there? How did that happen?
I went to Harvard thinking I was going to study economics. That's probably what I want to do.
Yeah.
And then I got there and I went to they have introductory meetings at the Lampoon. And I went and they're in this weird circular library and everyone in there smoking. And even now, everyone's there smoking all the time and reading, you know, magazines and they introduce every, you know, drinking a beer, which seemed like the coolest thing in the world to me,
right.
as someone who didn't drink through all of high school. And they just seemed funny. They seemed like funny people.
Yep.
And it was people like BJ Novak, who's now, you know...
From
you
The
know,
Office?
Yes, was there. Right. It was just people that were, and a lot of comedy writers who write for yep. The Simpsons or for The Office. And they were the funniest people that I saw on campus, and it seemed like an island within right. Harvard that was... a little bit more countercultural, and I don't know, they just seemed like they wanted to make each other laugh.
The very best networking thing. Environment, if this was going to be the career that you wanted, right? You couldn't ask for better people.
That's the odd thing, you don't know that till later, but the joy of the place is you kind of go because everyone there cares a lot about comedy. And it's rare to find
right.
people in freshman, sophomore year of college that they mainly want to do comedy.
Let
especially
alone at Harvard.
Yes.
I was about to say, it
yes.
is Harvard, right?
It was a fact I had to hide from my parents for a while.
Is that right? Yeah.
You know, but that's what you know, that
told
was
them
you were
still going to be an economist or
exactly.
whatever it was.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I'm going to be an economist and a lawyer and right. a doctor.